In today's episode of From Zero to Pentesting Hero, we will talk about why you shouldn't pass variables to assert function in PHP. Today we are going to take a close look at one of the tasks from Hack.lu CTF. We get the source code of the application. Our goal is to pass such parameters that will cause the last line to show, it is so-called flag. Let's try from the very beginning. We will copy the file to our local server. We'll also enable error handling by commenting the line with error reporting. Thanks to this, if the script returns an error, we will know about it. First, we need to bypass the file.contents function. It is responsible for downloading the contents of files and returning them as a string. The result of this function is compared to the hello challenge string. So in order to go further, we need to know the name of the file that contains this content. However, the probability that such file exists on the attacked server is zero. Therefore, there must be some other way of attack. In PHP, we have so-called filters. Then, when passed as a parameter to the function, make it behave a bit differently. One of such filters is data.explain. When passed as a parameter, instead of opening a file with the given name, it displays the content encoded in base64. We must therefore encode the hello challenge into base64 and then append it to the filter. Now, we can encode everything to the encoding recognized by the browser and pass it to the message parameter. As you can see, we are one step ahead. The next task is to bypass the int value function that returns integer from the given string. We are dealing here with a Boolean operator OR. So in order to go further, the result of the eval function must be equal to the CC variable, that is 1337, and in addition to the parameter passed to the eval function must differ from 1337. The solution is very easy. Eval works in such way. It reads a string starting from the very beginning until it finds the first non-digit character. So if we pass 1a, it will return 1. If we pass 23b, it will return 23. So in our case, we have to pass 1337 and that will meet the first condition. The second one will also be satisfied because the CC variable is a number and the key one parameter is a string. Three equality signs were used to compare variables, that is, in addition to the value, the variable type is also checked. In our case, string and int are two different types. The third step is a regular expressions. We know that the key2 parameter must have exactly 42 characters, thanks to the string length function. Then, using a regular expression, we check if there are only numbers in the given string. The caret means that we check the string from its first sign. The dollar sign, on the other hand, that we check the whole string to its last sign. An additional condition that we must meet is that the given parameter cannot be a number. So, how do you make the string contains only numbers, but not to be a number itself? Here, the authors of the task used a clever solution. The dollar sign that they used is not a real dollar sign. To show this difference, we will present a real dollar sign next to that used by the creators. The characters are similar, but not the same. So, if you do not use the dollar sign, it means that the string must start with at least one digit and then the fake dollar sign must occur. The rest of the sequence is not checked. It just so happens that a string with a fake dollar sign is not treated as a number by the isNumeric function. So we create any number, append the fake dollar sign, and fill the remaining numbers so that the whole string is equal to 42 characters. Remember, however, that the dollar sign is saved in different encoding and PHP counts it as 3 characters. A double equality sign is used here, which is somewhat similar to the inValue function. So we modify our content so that it starts from 1337, then a fake dollar and the rest of the characters. Now we can set the CC parameter. Next, with the help of substring function, the script retrieves all characters from the CC parameter starting with the 42 letter. And then checks if the string is equal to SHA-1 hash of the contents of the CC parameter. At first glance, it looks like finding collisions in the SHA-1 function. It is probably possible, but it took over a year from people from Google and they had many more resources. We must therefore look for an alternative solution. When we take a look at the PHP manual, we see that the SHA-1 function expects the CC parameter to be a string. What would happen if we pass array there? Let's see. In PHP, if the argument name ends with square brackets, it is treated as an array. As you can see, we are one more step further. Why? In PHP, if we pass tables to the SHA-1 function, it returns null. Substring returns false if the string is too short, as in this case. If you look at the table, we will see that null with false gives true, all the magic of PHP. The next line is very deceptive. It looks differently in the browser than in our text editor. Do you see the difference? How is this possible? We will use the Google Chrome development tools to check the code. We can see here a line with ampersand, hash and value of 8238. Quick googling reveals that this is the so-called right-to-left sign mainly used in Arabic languages. After using it, subsequent characters are displayed in reversed order. You can see it when you hover over in the console. Here, they are displayed in the correct order, but the browser reversed them. Our text editor displays them correctly. However, a strange syntax is used here. $2 signs before the a value. In PHP, these are so-called variable variables. The easiest way to demonstrate this is by example. Let's look at the Stack Overflow. We display the contents of the name variable here. First, we take its value, that is real variable, and then we look for a variable with exactly that name, and only then we display it. In this case, real variable has a value of test, and exactly this value will appear on our screen. Let's get back to the code. $2 signs were used here with the a variable. The a variable in the line above has the value of b assigned. So we take the value of b, that is 2. That is, to go further, the value of q1 must be equal to 2. Unfortunately, we have already set q1 to 1337 to meet the previous conditions. Therefore, we cannot make the variable once equal to 1337 and the second time to be 2. And here comes the rescue, the line with for each. With it, we can overwrite the value of any variable, because the variable variables construction is used here. This time it is enough to pass 2 in the parameter named q1. In this way, in line 40, the value of q1 will be set to 2. We have the last condition to fulfill. The assert function checks if the given condition is met, and if it's not, it ends the program execution. This is visible in the last line with an error, where we see that 42 is not equal to array. 42 is the value of the BB variable and array is the value of the CC variable. We cannot modify the value of CC here, because it is needed earlier when we bypassing the SHA-1 function. This may make us think that maybe the value of BB should be changed. We can change it using variable variables construction. Let's try to change it to array. This time, we received a message that array and array cannot be compared with each other. Strange, right? Also, the message in the line above changed to syntax error. It appears when the code passed to the PHP is incorrect. But just a moment ago, this line wasn't here. Where did it come from? When we look closer at the assert function, we can read that the string of characters passed to it is evaluated as a PHP code. That is, assert can be compared to the eval function. The array equal array is not valid. Let's try to put in some valid code there. For example, using the function die, which displays the parameter passed to it and ends the execution of the script. Thanks to this, even if the next part will be incorrect, the function should work. So let's try to display the contents of the flag, adding double slash to the string to make a comment of the rest of the data. Congratulations, we just displayed the contents of the flag. And that's all for today. A very interesting and non-trivial task that shows the danger of using the assert functionality. If you like this video, don't forget to leave a thumb up and subscribe. See you in the next episode. Bye!